guys, welcome to the third video in this video series where I'm trying to fill a sketchbook. So this video is going to be quite interesting, I think, because I'm doing some creative work here on this page where I'm just trying out some ideas, and then later on I'm designing some stickers that I actually made into a sticker pack. And I'm also doing some studies, which are also really important in a sketchbook. So yeah, I think this episode, I hope it will be interesting. I hope the studies won't be too boring to watch. Yeah, I'm not quite sure what to expect of this video, but I think it will be fun. And I hope you guys will find it fun too. So if you guys remember the first episode of this series, the very first page, I drew these like paint blobs, and then later on I drew on top of them and I made them into like cute little strawberries with different kind of faces. So I wanted to take that idea of just putting down the paint first and then drawing on top of it, and try that out with like animal stickers. So I think I often make my stickers like overcomplicated, and I wanted to make them a little bit less complicated, a little bit more easier to use, I think. And yeah, that's what I'm just trying out here. But I did these three leopard thingies that you just saw, and then I didn't really know what to do and I wasn't really warmed up, so I just jumped to the next page and started to do some gesture sketches. You know that you're the traveling kind, it's a known fact. Yeah, I know that. So some of you guys might already know this, but I quite often search a video of, for example, a dance video, and actually I will play the video and then either I will play it really really slowly and I do the gesture drawings while it's playing, but that is kind of difficult, I think. So often I'll just play it, put it randomly on pause and draw the gestures at that certain moment. And I've done this with dance videos, but I was thinking that maybe I'll reach out to other sports and do some other interesting poses. But I've been really enjoying the dance videos, so yeah. It gives you a lot of really interesting poses. I have been like drawing the videos of the same dance workouts that I also actually do. So I work out every day and I do dance workouts. And I've been drawing those poses in those videos. I thought maybe it would also help me learn to dance a little bit better. But I do notice that all those videos are shot exactly from the front. And maybe I should look for some music videos in which people are also dancing. And then maybe they will also have more interesting shots. Get a little bit of perspective in there to practice some more dynamic poses. But yeah, I'll have to look into that. But this, yeah, so this was a dance video and I had tons of fun. So in almost all my sketchbooks, I do these gesture drawings that I try to just get a little better in drawing people. I actually also have a different sketchbook that has really cheap paper in it, which I often carry with me whenever I go outside. And then I'll try to draw people in real life, and they're just standing around in the city or waiting in line. And I try to get some more gesture practice in real life, because I do think that there's like a lot of value in drawing from real life. And something that I've noticed is that when you're choosing on the internet what your reference is and what you would want to draw, you get a very narrow vision on what you actually want to draw. And if you go to the field, to the open big world, you don't really get to choose what you see in front of you. So I'll take that sketchbook and I'll just look around, and whoever I see, I'll draw them. I don't really choose. I try not to choose, actually. And so I'm hoping that will give me like a little bit more of a variation in body types that I can draw, and like broaden my visual library to just get easier to different kinds of IDs than just my narrow vision that I see on the internet. To find myself, a way to get myself. So here you see I've jumped back to the previous page. I wanted to try out this idea with the painting and the leopards or cat-like creatures a little bit more. And I had a watercolor piece that I didn't really like, so I decided to cut it up and use the backs of that paper in my sketchbook. And here I'm actually trying to work with a little bit more gouache and I'm trying that ID out for like, I don't know, I wanted to keep it really relaxed, because I often find that when I'm working in my sketchbook, I am really relaxed, and then as soon as I step into the real watercolor paper, all the relaxing is gone, and then I'm just really stiff and it doesn't work anymore. So I hope that if I wanted to stick these pieces in my sketchbook, that it would still keep me relaxed. But I don't know, I'm not really happy with how they turned out, and I'm not sure why. I just feel like something is off, or if it doesn't really like fit where I want to go with sticker designs and stuff. Maybe I still made them a little bit too complicated, or maybe the pen just wasn't the right ink or something. I don't know. Or the colors are a bit off. Now I'm looking at it. Maybe that's it. But it was a really good practice. And in the end, I think it made a really nice page in my sketchbook to look at. So it's okay. It's okay to make something you're not totally happy with. I think that if I have the motivation that I want to go back to this idea and try it out again, maybe stylize it even more. Maybe part of the problem here was that I'm not really good at drawing cat-like. Like the bigger cats, I'm not really good at them yet. I mean, I practice some, but that's not nearly enough. I mean, I did like, what, 8 drawings? Maybe some more. That's not nearly enough to know a subject. So maybe I'll draw some more big cats and then I'll try this again. But I don't know yet. I'll have to see what I want to work on when I'm working again in the sketchbook. Call us crazy, but things are finally right. With you and I, the future is bright. Thank you. some of you might know, I've been really into bullet journaling lately. And so these strawberry stickers that I designed on the first page of this sketchbook, those were actually designed to be mood tracker stickers. So the idea is that every day you see how, in general, your mood of the day was. So maybe something bad happened and your mood was really bad, but maybe something really good happened. And then you can look back at the month and see how in general you felt in the month. And maybe you can see that your mood is improving, or maybe you can see that you were going through like a rather down phase. And here I just wanted to make like a hand lettered. Yeah, I just called it mood berries because someone on Instagram said, "Oh, those are so cute, they're mood berries." And I thought, yeah, I'll take that name. That sounds nice. So that's why I'm doing that here. And so I'm practicing all types of hand lettering. And I'm not really good in it yet, but I'm having a lot of fun. And I think it actually looks quite nice. So yeah, I have this whole page filled with mood berries. And it was a fun, quick way to fill a page. And I learned something, so I'm happy with it. This very last page I'm working on for this video is also going to be a very, very rough one, because this is something that I often do in my sketchbook. I'll just fill a page with rough thumbnails with IDs, and then maybe I'll put like a single wash of watercolor under it to make it more interesting. Here in general, I did the first page of my bullet journal, and it had a panda with sunflowers on it, and a lot of people liked it, so I thought, well, maybe I'll design a sticker pack around that ID. But I didn't have any sketches or IDs yet, so I thought, oh, I'll show that in this sketchbook, then you guys can also look a little bit more into my process, and I thought you guys might find that interesting. With you, everything was complete. Do you know how much I love you? I put your favorite song on just to wake you up when I dance. I had a ton of fun again. I really like how this sketchbook is still going. I feel really good about the pages that I've made, and I feel like I may be loosening it up a little bit and getting slowly a little bit less stiff while drawing on camera. I hope you guys enjoyed this video too. If you have anything to say about it, be sure to leave me a comment. If you liked the video, be sure to like it. And if you would like to see more of me, then it would be great if you could subscribe to my channel. And yeah, I'll hope to see you in the next video. Bye! Loving this moment. Can we stay here forever?